This is the equation, that is d delta by a by p. So in order to find the maximum value of this ratio a by p, we have to take the derivative with respect to theta. And if you find the maximum value, you can find easily that maximum condition for the maximum velocity, right? We know that a is equal to how much, and that we have already calculated this weighted area in last lecture, that is on the flow through the circular channel. So weighted area is equal to how much? R square into bracket theta into minus sine 2 theta by 2 whole bracket close, right? So that then perimeter is equal to weighted perimeter 2 into R into theta, right? Now, so this is equation number 1, that is d theta by d theta of a by p. Now we have to take the derivative of this ratio, right? So this derivative, we can take the derivative by using this formula u by v, right? Now a is u and v. Now what is the formula of u, derivative of u by v? That is v into u dash minus u into v dash by v square, right? So therefore u is this and v is this. So therefore v is p into u dash is your a, that is da by d theta, minus u into u is your a into v dash, that is dp by d theta, divided by v square, that is nothing but p square, is equal to 0. I equate this p square to that side, right? So it will become 0, right? So therefore what is the remaining term? So p into da by d theta minus a into dp by d theta is equal to 0. So this is equation number 2, right? After this, now we know area. Now we have to find out this value da by d theta and dp by d theta, right? So we know area is equal to how much? R square into theta into minus sine 2 theta by 2, right? So we have to find out this da by d theta. So means what? We have to take the derivative of this area with respect to theta. So da by d theta is equal to R square into bracket, right? So what is the derivative of theta? That is 1 minus, what is the derivative of sine 2 theta? That is 1 by 2. Take the 1 by 2 a common, that is a constant term, into derivative of sine 2 theta is cos 2 theta into 2 whole bracket close, right? So this 2 will cancel. So what is the remaining term? Da by d theta is equal to R square into 1 minus cos 2 theta. So we'll get this da by d theta is equal to how much? R square into 1 minus cos 2 theta, right? This is equation number 3. Now after this, now we have to find out this dp by d theta. So what is perimeter? 2 into R into theta, right? Now take the derivative of this perimeter with respect to theta. So dp by d theta is equal to 2 into R, derivative of theta is 1, right? So we have just used that formula of u into v formula, that is u into v dash plus v into u dash, right? Now what is u? Here 2r and v is theta. This is u and this v. So u is how much? 2r into v dash is theta 1 plus v is theta into derivative of this 2r is 0. It is a constant. So therefore 2r. This is equation number 4, right? After that, put equation 3 and 4, this equation 3 and 4 in equation 2, this equation number 2. So you'll get what? P into R square 1 minus cos 2 theta minus A into 2R is equal to 0. After putting this dA by d theta and dP by d theta, right? So now modify that equation. So we know that P is equal to how much? 2 into R into theta bracket R square into whole bracket into R square into bracket 1 minus cos 2 theta bracket close whole bracket close minus R square. What is the weighted area? Weighted area is nothing but R square into theta minus sine 2 theta by 2 bracket close into 2R is equal to 0, right? So this is your what? Modified equation, right? So this is our what? Modified equation. Now after this, right? So now, so just multiply this term 2R theta into this bracket. So 2 into R cube into theta bracket 1 minus cos 2 theta. And this R square into 2R, how much it is? 2R cube into theta minus sine 2 theta by 2 bracket close is equal to 0, right? Now after this, then, so this 2R cube is a common term. So take it outside, this 2R cube. So 2R cube is common, bracket theta into 1 minus cos 2 theta minus sine 2 theta by 2 bracket close, whole bracket close is equal to 0. Now take this 2R cube to that side, that will be 0. So therefore, after this, Now, so just multiply this theta into this bracket. So theta into minus cos 2 theta into theta. So take this minus term to bracket into the bracket. Therefore, minus theta plus sin 2 theta by 2 bracket close is equal to 0. Right. So after this, now theta theta will cancel. Right. Then remaining term is cos 2 theta into minus cos 2 theta into theta plus sin 2 theta by 2 is equal to 0. Right. Now after this, so therefore, now take this cos minus cos 2 theta into theta to that side. So therefore, sin 2 theta by 2 into is equal to cos 2 theta into theta. Right. So now take this cos 2 theta to 2 theta to this side. So therefore, sin 2 theta by cos 2 theta and take this 2 to that side. So that is nothing but 2 theta. So therefore, sin 2 theta by cos theta is equal to 2 theta and it is equal to tan 2 theta is equal to sin cos theta by cos 2 theta is nothing but tan 2 theta is equal to 2 theta. So therefore, by hit and trial method, so this 2 theta is equal to how much? 257 degree 30 minute. So therefore, theta is equal to how much? 180 degree 45 minutes. Means what? So if theta is this much, then velocity will be maximum. So this is the condition for the maximum velocity, right? Now after this, if theta changes, means what? So if this is the theta, what about the depth of the flow, right? What about the depth? Now we have calculated that theta is equal to how much? 128 degree 45 minute. Means at this degree the velocity will be maximum. Now so this depth of flow, now we have to calculate the what is the depth of the flow for the maximum velocity, right? What is the depth of the flow? Now we know that what is the depth of the flow. So this much is the depth of the flow. Now just see here. So depth of the flow, this much is the depth of the flow. How much is depth of the flow? This much, that is CD. You can see in the figure, that is CD. Depth of the flow is equal to CD, right? So therefore, so I can write, or you can write that CD is equal to nothing but OD minus OC, right? So this CD is nothing but this OD minus this OC, right? If you minus, you will get that CD, right? How much is OD? We know that OD is nothing but that radius of that circle, that is R, minus. What about this OC? Right. So this angle is theta. Right. So if you see this triangle AOAC, in that, what is cos theta? In this triangle OAC, what is cos theta? That is nothing but this OC adjacent side divided by hypotenuse, that is R. So therefore, OC is equal to how much? R into cos theta, right? So that is nothing but R into cos theta, right? So therefore, what is hydraulic mean depth? Sorry, the depth of the flow is R into 1 minus cos theta, right? So this is your hydraulic, depth of the flow, right? So why we are calculating this depth of the flow? Because this depth of the flow, if you see, this depth of the flow contains this term theta, right? So for that purpose, we have to find out what is the depth of the flow at the maximum velocity, right? So therefore, D is equal to, how much is R? R we don't know. 1 minus cos is, how much is what theta? That is 128 degree 45 minute, right? Now, after this, if you find this, right, so we'll get what? R into 1 plus 0.62, right? So we'll get this depth of the flow is equal to R into 1 plus 0.62. That is nothing but 1.62 R. This is the depth of the flow is equal to 1.62 into R. R. So R is nothing but, that is the D by 2. That is nothing but diameter of that circular channel by 2. Therefore, 1.62 into D by 2. I can write like this. So 1.62 into D by 2. So therefore, D is equal to how much? So that is 0.18 D. Right. So what is the meaning of this? Means the depth of the flow is maximum when, or the velocity of the velocity through that circular channel section is maximum when that depth of the flow is equal to 0.8 times the diameter of that circular channel section. So this is the condition number 2, or this is condition number 2. That is nothing but depth of the flow is equal to 0.8 times d, means at this that velocity will be maximum.